So for question number 21, answer is in page number 222. So under the topic concentration of reactants. So for question number 22, so the answer is in page number 222. So under the topic nature and state of a reactant. So next question number 23. So the rate constant for a first order reaction is 1.54 into 10 power minus 3 second. Calculates its half life period. So first order reaction oda half life vandu ketirukanga. So already we know the formula. So first order oda half life period oda formula vandu T half equal to 0.693 divided by K. So K value namakku vandu kuduthirukranga rate constant value. So adha vandu inga vandu substitute pandrom. So 1.54 into 10 power minus 3 second power minus 1 nu inga poduvom already. So idu rendu 0.693 yum 1.54 cancel panna namakku 450 abin value kadikum. So inga second vandu minus la irukkanaala, so adu mele numerator ku pona adu enna maarum, second ah vandu maaridum. So next question number 24. The half life of the homogeneous gaseous reactions SO2Cl2 gives SO2 plus Cl2, which obeys the first order kinetics, is 8 minutes. So how long will it take for the concentration of SO2Cl2 to be reduced to 1% of the initial value? So first order ங்கறனால அதோட half life அந்த formula வந்து என்னது, first அத எழுதுவோம் T half equal to 0.693 divided by K னு வரும். சோ நமக்கு என்ன தேவைனா K value தேவை. சோ K வந்து அந்த சைடு எடுத்துன்னு போயிரோம். சோ K equal to 0.693 divided by T half னு வரும். சோ T half ஓட value questionல இருக்குது. சோ that value is 8. சோ அத வந்து substitute பண்றோம். சோ next 0.693 8 ஆல் divide பண்ணும்போது நமக்கு என்ன answer கிடைக்கும், 0.087. So minutes ki denominator la irukanaala, so the mele pona namakku inverse ah vandu maariradhu. So first order rate equation next edrom K equal to 2.303 divided by K log of A naught divided by A. Okay, so idhula vandu namakku enna thevana, here inge vandu T nu varum, 2.303 divided by T not a K. So inge vandu namma enna pandrom, T வந்து அந்த சைடு எடுத்து போறோம், K வந்து இங்க எடுத்து போறோம். சோ 2.303 divided by, சோ நமக்கு K ஓட வேல்யூ வந்து என்ன கிடைச்சது, 0.087. அது வந்து இங்க சப்ஸ்டிட்யூட் பண்றோம் into log of, சோ இனிஷியலா அதோட கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன் வந்து என்ன இருக்கும், 100%. சோ 100% இருந்ததோட SOCl2 ரிடூஸ் ஆகி 1% மாறுது. சோ அப்ப கீழ அதோட ஆஃப்டர் சம் டைம் 100 ல இருந்து என்னவா மாறுது, 1% மாறுது. சோ அத வந்து கீழ வந்து சப்ஸ்டிட்யூட் பண்றோம் ரைட். சோ log 100 nu varum, so adukku vandu or value kadaikum. So and then we are going to cancel this one. So cancel panna namakku enna value kadaikum, T is equal to 52.93. so inge vandu minute vandu minus la irukanaala, so numerator ponna adu enna va maarum, minutes ah maaridum. Here mm nu type a irukudhu, so you need to correct this one. So minute. So next question number 25. So the time for half change in a first order decomposition of a substance A is 60 seconds. Calculate the rate constant. How much of A will be left after 180 seconds? So per T half வந்து என்ன கொடுத்திருக்காங்க, 60 second. So T half ஓட value வந்து என்ன, 0.693 divided by K. So அப்ப k value நமக்கு தேவை. So அது k அந்த சைடு எடுத்து போயிடு, so t half கீழ வந்திருது. So அப்ப 0.6931 divided by 60. So next வந்து 0.6931 60 ஆல டிவைட் பண்ணா நமக்கு என்ன வேல்யூ கிடைக்குது, 0.01155 செகண்ட் இன்வர்ஸ் ரைட். So next வந்து என்ன பண்றோம், first order rate equation எழுதுறோம். K equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of A naught divided by A. So, if k oda value vandu namakku enna kadichathu 0.01155. So, adu edhirum equal to 2.303 divided by time vandu enna irukku kuduthirukanga 180 second. So, appo 180 inga substitute pandrom log மேல வந்து இனிஷியலா நம்ம எடுத்துக்கிற கான்சன்ட்ரேஷன் எவ்வளவு இருக்கும் 100. சோ டிவைடட் பை a. aங்கற வேல்யூ கொடுக்கல, அதான் நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்க போறோம். சோ அந்த a-வை அப்படியே வெச்சுக்கோம். ரைட். சோ இந்த log 100 பை a தான் a கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுனால இத மட்டும் லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைடு வெச்சிட்டு சோ ரிமைனிங் எல்லாத்தையுமே ரைட் ஹேண்ட் சைடு கொண்டு போறோம். சோ அது எப்படி எப்படி சேஞ்ச் ஆகுது? சோ log of 100 டிவைடட் பை a equal to 0.01155. So இது வந்து cross multiply பண்ணி மேல போயிடுது. So into 180 divided by 2.303. So இது log form ல இது வந்து division ல இருக்குது. So அது வந்து எப்படி எழுதுறது? So log of 100. So இது மேல போறனால minus of log a equal to. So இது cancel பண்ணா நமக்கு என்ன answer கிடைக்கும்? 0.9207. So அப்ப 100 ங்கிறது வந்து என்ன? 10 स्क्वायर दा 100, सो अपन log 10 स्क्वायर ने इधरों माइनस log ये इक्वल टू 0.9207, सो अपन इन द 2 उंगल मेल पावर लर का 2 मिनट ही बंदर द, सो 2 log of 10 माइनस log ये इक्वल टू 0.9207, सो log ये दा नमक टेव, सो log ये वहीं अपने वेज़ रिमाइनिंग इलाके आंदर सेट कोण्ड पोरो, राइट, सो log a இந்த சைடு வந்தா அது வந்து பாசிட்டிவா மாறிடும். சோ இங்க இருக்குற 0.9207 இந்த சைடு வந்தா அது வந்து மைனஸா மாறிடும். சோ அப்ப 2 0.9207 ஓட வேல்யூ வந்து 1.0973. சோ அப்ப இந்த சைடு இது a மட்டும் தான் நமக்கு தேவை. சோ அப்ப log வந்து அந்த சைடு போயிடுது. அண்ட் இந்த சைடு போனா அது ஆன்டி லாக் ஆ மாறும். சோ ஆன்டி லாக் ஆஃப் 1.0973 ஓட வேல்யூ வந்து பார்த்தோம்னா 12.5. சோ அப்ப a கான்சன்ட்ரேஷனோட அம் परसेंटेज வந்து 12.5%. நெக்ஸ்ட் क्वेश्चन நம்பர் 25. தி டைம் ஃபார் a half change in a first order decomposition of a substance a is 60 seconds. Calculate the rate constant. How much of a will be left after 180 seconds? So the order of the reaction is 1, t half equal to 60 seconds. So k, the rate constant, that only asked in the question. So rate constant k is equal to k, that only we are going to calculate. So we know that k is equal to 2.303 divided by t half. So t half is 60 seconds now. So we are going to put the 60 here. So next we need to divide 2.303 divided by 60. So we are getting 0.01155 per second. So and then a not equal to 100%. See the question now. So a not equal to 100%. How much of a will be left after 180 seconds? So t equal to 180 second, k value, this k value equal to 0.01155 per second. So a is equal to that only we are going to calculate. So first, next we need to write the first order equation, rate equation. So k is equal to 2.303 divided by t into log of a naught divided by a. So k value 0.01155 equal to 2.303 divided by, so time is 180 seconds. So divided by 180, log of a naught value 100. So 100 divided by a. So next we are going to this 180 is moves to the another side numerator. So into 180, this 2.303 moves to that another side. So divided by 2.303 equal to log of 100 divided by a. So we are cancel everything, means we are getting 0.9207 equal to it's in that division form. So we changed that a into minus minus here. So log 100 minus log a. So a only we are going to calculate. So we need to bring that log a in that left hand side. So minus sign is there. So while bring while changing into the another side, that negative sign is changed into the positive here. So log A equal to log 100. So this one is in the positive side. So it moves to the another side, means that one changed into the negative sign here. So minus 0.9207. So log A equal to, so log 100 value is 2. So 2 minus 0.9207. So log A equal to 1.0973. is the answer. So we are going to calculate only A. So we need to move that log into that another side. So that log is changed into the anti-log here. So anti-log of 1.0973. So anti-log for this value is 12.5. So the concentration of A is 12.5%. So next question number 26. So a zero order reaction is 20% complete in 20 minutes. Calculate the value of the rate constant. So in what time will reaction be 80% complete? So initially A concentration is 100%. So x is equal to 20%. So and then A minus x is equal to, we are getting 80. So next we are going to enter into rate constant value. K is equal to x by t. So x value is 20 divided by again t value. T is 20 seconds here. So 20 divided by 20, we are getting 1. So rate constant of the reaction equal to 1. So next, what is asking in the question, in what time will be the reaction be 80% complete? To calculate the time for 80% of completion, K is equal to, so that means rate constant equal to 1 here, A is equal to, so that means initial concentration is 100. So after some time, so it changes into that 80%. So after what time it will reach the 80%? The time is asking in the question. So K is equal to x by t, we know. So in the question, they are asking that time. So t, so we just change that formula. So we are getting t is equal to x by k. So x value is 80 here, so divided by k value is 1. So we are getting 80 minutes. So next question number 27. So the energy of activation of a reaction is 225 kilocalorie per mole. So the value of rate constant at 40 degrees Celsius is 1.8 × 10⁻⁵ seconds. So calculate the frequency factor A. So here we are given that. So EA value is 22.5 kilocalorie per mole is given there. So we need to change the kilocalorie into calorie form. So it's changed into 22.5 × 10³ calorie per mole. Temperature is in Celsius form. So we need to change that one in the Kelvin form. So we need to add 40 plus 273. So we are getting 313 Kelvin. So and then K value is 1.8 × 10⁻⁵ seconds. So frequency A factor A is asking in the question. So and then R value, so that is rate constant value. So actually we are using 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole only. So that in the question, the units are given in calories. So we changed that R in the form of, so 1.987 calorie per Kelvin per mole. So next we are going to enter all the data in the Arrhenius equation. So K is equal to A into e power minus Ea by RT. So next we are going to take log for this formula. So log K equal to log A minus, so E is cancelled. Once we multiply this log with E, means that one is cancelled. So we are getting minus Ea by RT. So next we are going to calculate the log A only. So we need to bring the A in the left hand side. So log A equal to, so log K. So this one moves to the other side. So the sign is changed into positive. So plus Ea by 2.303 × RT. So log A equal to, so the K value already we know, see that. So K value is 1.8 × 10⁻⁵ seconds. So that only we are enter here, plus Ea value. CEA value is 22.5 into 10 power 3 divided by 2.303 into R value is 1.987 into temperature is 313. So next, we are multiplied the log with throughout that bracket. So log into 1.8 we are getting log 1.8. So we need to multiply this log with 10 power minus 5 we are getting minus 5 here plus. So we are cancel everything means we are getting 15.708. So log A equal to. So log A equal to 10.9642 is the value. So from that we need to calculate only A. So we need to bring that log into that another side. It is changed into that anti-log. So A equal to anti-log of 10.9642. So anti-log of this value equal to so 9.208 into 10 power 10 pollutions per second. So next question number 28. Benzene diazonium chloride in aqueous solution decomposes. So according to that equation. So starting with an initial concentration of 10. So volume of N2 gas obtained at 50 degrees Celsius at different intervals of time were found to be. So the volume of NO2 is calculated at different time intervals. So from that, what is asking? So what is the value of the rate constant? So K is asking here. So first order kinetics is given in that question. So we need to write that first order rate equation. So K equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of A by A minus X. So here A is the term A is not using here. So volume is using. So we are changing that A into V form. So V infinity divided by V infinity by VT. So X we are taken as VT. So in this case, infinity value, the V infinity value is 58.3 ml. So the value of K at different time can be calculated as follows. So at that time, 6 minutes, that volume of that nitrogen is 19.3. Next, we need to subtract that V infinity minus VT value. So what is V infinity value? 58.3 minus 19.3. So we are getting 39.0. So that this value we are going to enter into that first order rate equation. So K is equal to 2.303. T is 60 minutes. So divided by 6 into log of V infinity value is. So 58.3 divided by V infinity minus VT value, so 39. So we are getting the answer 0.0670 per minute. So next T value 12, VT value 32.6. So V infinity value is common for all the values. So 58.3 minus 32.6, we are getting 25.7. So next we are going to enter this value in first order rate equation. So K is equal to 2.303 divided by, so this time is 12. So we need to enter 12 here. So 12 into log of 58.3 divided by, so this V infinity by minus VT value 25.7. So we are getting 0.0683 per minute. So next time is 18 second, VT value 41.3. So and then V infinity minus VT value. So V infinity is common for all, 58.3 minus 41.3 equal to 17. So that one we are going to enter in that equation. So K is equal to 2.303 divided by 18 into log of 58.3 divided by 17. So we are getting 0.0685 per minute. So next time is 24 minutes, VT value is 46.5. So next we are going to calculate V infinity minus VT. So V infinity value is 58.3 minus 46.5. So we are getting 11.8 here. So this 11.8 we are going to enter in the first order rate equation. k equal to 2.303 divided by 24 into log of 58.3 divided by 11.8. So we are getting 0.0666 per minute. So next fifth one, time we have taken as 30. So on the VT value 50.4. So on the V infinity minus VT value. So that is V infinity value is 58.3 minus 50.4. We are getting 7.9. So this 7.9 we are going to enter in the rate equation. So K is equal to 2.303 divided by 30 log of 58.3 divided by 7.9. So we are getting 0.0666 minute. So next we need to add all the k value, means we are getting mean value of k. So that one we need to add all the 5 k value. So and then divided by 5. So we are getting 0.0674 per minute. So that is the mean value of k. So next question number 29. From the following data, show that the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is the reaction is of the first order. So where T is the volume of a standard KMnO4 solution required for titrating the same value of the reaction mixer. So the volume of KMnO4 solution used amount of H2O2 present. Hence, if the given reaction is of the first order, so first next we need to write that first order rate equation. So that is K equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of A by A minus X. So that concentration is given in volume. So we need to write as V. So V naught by VT. So in this case, V naught equal to, so first one, V naught equal to Y initial concentration, initial volume is 46.1 ml. So initial time at that time zero VT value is 46.1. So next we are going to enter the data in the first order rate equation. So T is equal to 2.303. Now that time is zero here. So T is zero, log of, so V zero value is 46.1 and the VT value also 46.1. So equal to zero we are getting. So and then second one. So at the 10 minutes, so the volume of VT equal to 29.8. So 2.303 divided by time T value is 10, log of, so V0 initial value is 46.1 divided by, so VT value, this value 29.8. So we are cancelled, means we are getting 0.0436 per minute. So and then now when the time is 20 minutes, so VT value is, so 19.3. So next we are going to enter that value in the rate equation. So K equal to 2.303 divided by this T value. So divided by 20, log of, so V0 value, that is initial value 46.1 divided by, so this VT value 19.3. So we are getting 0.0435 per minute. So the value of K comes out to be nearly constant. So hence it is the first order rate equation. Sorry, first order, it is the first order reaction. So next question number 30. So a first order reaction is 40% complete in 15 minutes. So calculate the value of the rate constant. In what time will the reaction be 80% complete? So the first order rate equation, first we need to write. So K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of A by A minus X. So A value, that is initial concentration, is 100%. So X value is 40%. So T is 50 minutes here. So next we need to calculate A minus X. So A minus X equal to 100 minus 40, we are getting 60. So next we are going to enter all the data in the formula. So K is equal to 2.303 divided by, so this T value is 50 here. So divided by 50 into log of, so A value, that is initial concentration, is 100 divided by A minus X value is 60. So we are cancel everything, means we are getting 0.010216 per minute. So the value of the rate constant K is 0.010216 per minute. So next, what is asking in the question? In what time will the reaction be 80% complete? So T is equal T only we are going to calculate. So T x is equal to 80%. That is concentration is 80%. That means A minus x is equal to 100 minus 80. So we are getting 20 here. So K value is, so we find already we found that K value in the first distribution. So K value is 0.010216 per minute. So next we are going to enter all the data in the first order rate equation. So from that we are going to calculate the time only. So time is comes in the left hand side, K comes down. So T equal to 2.303 divided by this K value 0.010216 into log of, so A value is 100, so and then A minus X value is 20. So we are cancel everything, means we are getting T equal to 157.58 minutes. So the time at which 80% complete is, so at 80% complete the time is 157.58 minutes.
Thank you.